coming.
Charles Craig?
Good.
All right, I'm gonna read from, just to give you a little information, I'm gonna read from a script. I will describe it, will not be taking any questions post-reading of the script. And then subsequently, Carla Austin, the Director of the Public Information Office, will answer some questions on process associated with release of the public information, okay? So on Friday, as you all have been now reporting, the Supreme Court denied a motion filed by the Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department to stay the release of the documents associated with 1 October until a later date. There are many reasons why we didn't or couldn't release the hundreds of records and body cam footage immediately following the incident. Primarily, we were still investigating all the circumstances associated with 1 October. Second, there was the issue of manpower. It takes a significant amount of effort and resources for detectives to review, approve body camera footage, 911 recordings, and documents for release. Per the court order and law, we will redact certain aspects of these items for privacy reasons. Third, cost is a legitimate issue. To comply with the court's order, it will cost the LVMPD and the public several hundred thousand dollars in manpower, time, and equipment. Fourth, the overall concerns of the victims and their families. To begin the process, the videos of two of our officers who had their body cameras activated during the portions of the entry into the suspect's hotel room will be released tomorrow. What is seen on those videos no way changes the facts that we were able to clarify for you shortly after the crime. The release of the videos, 911 recordings, and documents will be made on a rolling basis. For that reason, we caution you from making conclusions based on any single release. Further releases of this information will occur on a regular basis, which we anticipate in approximately 2 weeks. As I promised you, when we released our preliminary investigation, a final report will be issued which summarizes all of the investigation and available information. That report will also give context to the different documents that we have been ordered to release. Internally, the task of preparing this release for all of you will not be easy. Many of our employees will have to endure reliving the incident. We are assembling detectives who we pulled from various assignments on the department to go over reports and body camera footage in preparation for release. Keep that in mind. We have to reassign detectives in order to accomplish this task, taking them away from their primary responsibility. At no point was the LVMPD trying to be uncooperative with the media or the public. We were operating the way we have always operated, making sure the important facts were released and that the public was in no danger following the 1 October incident. I can tell you now, we will not be granting interviews with employees as we feel this will be a burden. We as a department are trying to complete the investigation and heal as a community. I want the community to know the release of the videos, 911, and documents will have a significant impact on the victims of this tragedy. We believe the release of the graphic footage will further traumatize a wounded community. For that, we apologize. I don't know how this footage will be played in the media, but I want them to warn you, if you are a survivor or a family who lost a loved one, you should know the video from this concert is disturbing and graphic. We have always tried to protect the victims and their families of this incident. Further victimization is certain to occur and is something we wanted to avoid. Finally, please remember that a comprehensive final report on this incident is still forthcoming. It will answer questions that may be raised in the short term as our release of information is ongoing. The Vegas Strong Resiliency Center is still operating at 1524 Pinto Lane. They can be reached by calling 702-455-2433, or long distance, the number is 1-833-299-2433. I would encourage you to take advantage of this community resource where counseling is available. And that will be the end. Thank you. Carla?
Questions?
In terms of the redactions, will you, for the video, will you be blurring faces, or will you be eliminating entirely portions that show faces?
No, what we're going to try to... So, yeah, basically we're going to be complying with the court order. So there will be some items on the video that will not be able to, for, let's say someone is nude on a video, we will be blurring that particular portion out. So we're not attempting to blur entire videos out, but just segments that we think, because of privacy issues, need to be blurred out.
Carla, Jeff from News 3, can you just illuminate again what we'll be getting tomorrow? I think the sheriff said
the initial entry into the 32nd floor.
And that was with two officers, body cams with 12?
Correct. So we still have not worked out completely the process by which we are going to be releasing all of the video. It will be on a rolling basis, it should be on a weekly basis, but we haven't figured out exactly how we're going to get all that to you. We will have all of it figured out hopefully by tomorrow. So you will get those two videos initially tomorrow, and then we will email you instructions on how you guys will be able to obtain the video from us and all of the recordings and documents. So with that, anything else?
So that email would basically say we have to go there and get a CD.
I've just told you, I don't know yet. I don't know how it's going to be delivered. So I will have that information for you at the time that we figure that out. So whether it is that you have to physically come down here to pick something up, or we email it out, we will have that information for you.
Have you guys reached out to other organizations like Orlando? You have the same kind of similar situation where, you know, they released everything on a website. And have you reached out to any other jurisdictions on how they release documents like this?
I can't answer that. I don't know if our legal team did or not. I don't know that.
And the two videos tomorrow, those will be the only two videos we see this week?
Correct.
Okay.
You mentioned it has the initial entry to the 32nd floor. Does it show the inside of the room or anything inside?
Correct. Yeah. Whatever is on the body camera is what you're going to see.
How long are those videos?
I can't tell you that.
Carl, I apologize if you just addressed this. Did you say that you haven't worked out yet in terms of how we will be receiving, whether or not we come down here or you email them out?
Correct. I don't believe they will be emailed out. I can tell you that. I do not believe that. But again, this has required us to purchase computers and other equipment in order to make this happen. So we're still working on it. It's a large task. It's not something that is simple. It's not as simple as us just pressing a button and all of this is going to go out to all of you. So we're trying to figure it out still. We're working with outside resources as well. So once we figure all of it out and we have a system in place, we will email all of you and let you know how you will be able to obtain the information. But there will be a system in place so that every week you'll know how you're going to receive it.
And the sheriff was mentioning detectives are going to have to be pulled, so you won't be hiring more people, but if you have to pull detectives from their other duties, I guess going to be hurting?
Correct. Their workload. We have to. We don't have any other option. We have to find employees who work here to do the work. And so, obviously, there will be some other work that will probably be delayed or slowed as a result of these detectives being pulled from their normal duties in order to go through this footage and these videos and documents. So it's a large task. There's a lot of videos. There are hundreds of videos, actually more than a couple of thousand videos. and there's a lot of documents. So it's a labor-intensive process, and we have to go by it step by step in order to accomplish what the court is asking us to do.
Carla, will other investigations suffer because of this?
Well, I would say that they're going to be slowed. So I'm not going to use the terminology you are, but I will say that they will be slowed. Obviously, if we're pulling resources from one area of the department to accomplish this, that means that work in another area will definitely have to be delayed in some way, in some fashion. We will still attempt to accomplish it. Obviously, our priority is always the community and providing the best service that we can for people. We certainly don't want people to have to wait any longer than necessary when we're talking about solving crimes and completing people's investigations. But we have to move resources in order to accomplish a court mandate.
Because it's on a rolling basis, are we anticipating weeks, months of release?
I would say at the very least months.
And we don't know if it's going to be, I'm sorry, you may have said this before, every week something may be coming out, whether it's 911 tapes or body cam footage?
That's what I would anticipate.
In terms of just the overall scope of the October 1st investigation, how would you characterize where you are at this point in this whole?
You know what, Jeff, I know it would be great if I could stand here and answer all of your questions, but I'm not here to talk about the investigation. I'm here to simply give you some details on the release of these documents and these videos. So with that, if we don't have any other questions specific to that, I'm going to have to say thank you guys for all attending today.
I have one last question. So you mentioned thousands of videos. Any idea of how many documents or anything like 911 calls? Any other insight into what will be released?
I don't. I just know the documents are in the hundreds. But I'm sorry, I don't have a specific number. Thank you all.
Thanks a lot.